All right, so you look really good, big and strong. How long have you been training for, man?
Well, I've been training actually for a long time, but I had a few years break, and now I've been training since the beginning of this year. So, wow. 9 months, 10 months.
Awesome, yeah. Awesome.
So the question we're asking people today is, do you think you have to eat animals to be healthy and put on muscle mass?
Vegan tattoo?
Yeah.
Yep. yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Awesome. So you don't think you can get all your nutrients from plants?
No.
Okay. Do you know which specific nutrient you would need from animals?
What I've heard most is B12.
Okay. Yep.
Where do you get B12 from?
B12 found in the, well, B12 is a bacteria found in the dirt and in water.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So easily supplemented.
Supplemented, yeah. But I mean, going back in times when you didn't have supplements, then where did the guys get it from? If they were vegan, yeah.
Back in time, mm-hmm. Well, the vegetables, root vegetables picked from the ground would have dirt on them,
cool.
And they wouldn't be sanitized. Mm-hmm. So the B12 and bacteria would be on the vegetables, but because, you know, everything's sanitized now, the B12,
yeah.
You know, it's been added to the animal feed, mm-hmm. and injected into the animals as well. Mm-hmm. So if we took care of B12, what other nutrients do you feel like we'd have issues with?
What about essential amino acids?
Protein?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, so you can't get protein from plants, you don't think?
No, you do. I mean, protein is a combination of amino acids.
Oh, the correct combination of amino acids.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you think there are vegan bodybuilders that have...
No, I know there are.
There are?
There are, I know.
Wow.
Yeah.
What about John over here?
I guess, I mean, if you're asking questions like this, then he must be vegan also.
Yeah. He's onto us.
How long you guys been vegan for?
John?
I've been vegan for 3 years now.
3 years?
Yeah.
John's been vegan for 3 years, yeah. Yeah.
And what about, I mean, how long you been training?
So I've been training for about 5 years now.
Okay.
Yeah, so 2 of those years were with meat and animal, mm-hmm. products, and then 3 of them were as a vegan, plant-based.
I mean, objectively, how do you compare the weight gain? I mean...
Well, I have like a ton of videos online to see the transformation, mm-hmm. but at this body fat, when I switched to a plant-based diet, was, I'd say I was about 83 kilos. Now I'm about 93. Cool. So 3 years, that's a... Yeah, for a natural, it's a pretty good progress, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what's the... You got supplement, right?
I do take a B12. Yeah, I do take B12.
Like plant-based protein powders also?
Yeah, a couple times a week, yeah. Like when I'll throw in a smoothie if I'm having like a big workout or something, mm-hmm. yeah. But yeah, like anyone else, like I used to do it before as a meat eater as well. So like 4 times a week, I'll have a shake or something, mm-hmm. yeah, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so if...
So about you? How long have you been training?
A couple weeks. 2 weeks. I'm not a very good... measurement, but anyway, where I wanted to take this was animals obviously have to go to a slaughterhouse in order for us to eat their bodies, and for that individual animal, that mm-hmm. if it's not a life of hell,
yeah.
it's sort of taking their life unnecessarily.
I know, but back home, what I do is, and quite honestly,
yeah.
what I do is I buy grass-fed, like beef, and I know for a fact, I mean, the way they were raised and slaughtered and everything,
yeah.
so it's very, very ethically correct.
Okay.
So that's what I do. I mean, I know a lot of people don't do that, but I do.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah.
So all of your animals that you eat have been looked after and treated correctly?
Yep. Okay. I pay a little bit more, but that's what I do, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how about when they end up at the slaughterhouse, do you think that is ethical?
I mean, it's very fast. I mean, it's very quick the way they do it with the air gun. And I mean, ethically, I mean, I don't like animals being tortured, but if they're not being tortured, then...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So you a bolt gun in the head and a knife across the throat to drain their blood and stuff like that is... Do you think that is necessary if we can look like John and still get our nutrients and train and look...
I mean, everybody can't look like John.
Well, let's just say we can look somewhere near. We don't lose our gain. Potentially, he's obviously genetics come into it and other things. But if we've got evidence of more people mm-hmm. looking similar to John, do you think it's unnecessary to?
What
put
about let's talk about how plants are raised? I mean,
okay.
if everyone was vegan, even now,
yeah.
I mean, the area or the land where the plants are raised or grown, it's gotten a lot more dense. You know, a lot more. Plants on the same area of land, so they use a lot of pesticides. I mean, do you guys eat organic?
Not always, but
What about the land that's being poisoned because of the pesticides?
Yeah, that's an issue too. Plant agriculture isn't perfect, but if we were to think of how many of those crops are being fed to animals versus humans, it's to the magnitude.
Well, that's the idea. Animals are supposed to eat, like cows are supposed to eat grass. And I eat the animals, or some of the animals that eat grass.
Yeah.
They're ethically raised, so everything's done as properly as possible.
Yeah, so from an environmental perspective, grass-raised beef is less sustainable than factory-raised beef, but from an ethical...
Less sustainable?
It's less sustainable, yeah, because it's it takes up more land, and it's they create more methane gas.
Well, the way it's supposed to work is there's supposed to be a rotation. Basically, the animals eat the grass, then they... basically their shit supposed to be the manure and the fertilizer, I mean,
like biodynamic farming you're talking about,
basically, and then they move on to the next spot, and then they grow the plants, and that's the way it's supposed to be. So that's what I strive towards, or buying those products that are grown that way.
That's That might be considered better than obviously torturing an animal their whole life in a factory farm.
And also, I mean growing a crop or a plant on the same land like year round, like every year, then there's really no nutrients in the land anymore. They only grow because of the fertilizers and artificial stuff, basically. So you're not really getting any nutrients from it.
From the plants?
I mean, if there's nothing in the ground, the way the nutrients get into the plant is through the ground, and you're supposed to do a rotation.
Wow.
The ground is supposed to recover, from growing the plants.
So how do the animals get the nutrients in their body?
That's what I'm saying.
From the plants.
That's what I'm saying. I buy the animal products that are raised, grass-fed, basically.
Awesome.
Or pasture-raised or whatever, and they do the rotation.
So do you think there's a better way than killing these animals on the? Do you think we can sustain the whole planet on grass? Do you think there's a better way?
Back to killing animals, and I don't think it's ethical. I mean, torturing animals, that's what I'm saying, but if... Basically, that's what we've been doing...
For thousands of years.
Tens of thousands of years, hundreds of thousands of years, basically.
Yeah, we have.
Yeah.
Do you think we should continue doing it because we've done it forever, or do you think maybe we can move forwards and stop?
I think we should do it correctly, through the rotation and ethically correctly and everything. Then it's sustainable.
So you would...
And at the end of the day, if you look at the peak picture, there's just too many of us anyway.
Yeah, do you think we can sustain the whole population on these grass-fed cattle and out the back of, we've got 7 billion people?
I don't know, I would need to look at some statistics, but I mean...
There's a lot of people. Plants we can feed a lot more people
with. Maybe we can get a huge catastrophe or something. You know, if you look at history, then there's always been a cataclysmic event or something, and the human population has reduced, and we've grown again, but now it's so big again that it's moving towards the direction that it's not sustainable anymore, and there's
not
probably something coming, who knows, you know?
Well, what about if we all ate plants instead of these animals, which are obviously...
That's not sustainable either, I mean...
Really?
Because you're talking about basically plant factory farming. That's what I spoke about, the fertilizers and the pesticides and everything. And if you grew the plants basically organically, then the plants wouldn't grow on the same area of land all year round every year.
But we'd need less land to grow plants?
Because even if you look at wheat, then wheat was a lot different Let's take Ezekiel wheat. You know it? Ezekiel?
Yeah.
Okay. So basically the crop was a lot shorter, and basically you need a lot more land. So back in the days, let's say thousands of years ago, you had a lot less plants growing on the same area of land. But there was the thing was that there was a lot fewer us also.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. So we obviously... cutting down the rainforest to grow soybeans, to feed to these animals. So
I don't approve of growing soybeans.
We're feeding the soybeans to cows and stuff
that's
like that.
What they
and
do
they're clearing land for grass-fed
that's
beef.
That's what they do in factory farming, yeah.
And they're also
and I don't agree with factory farming.
And they're clearing the land for grass-fed cattle as well in the Amazon and stuff like that. That's probably the main. That is the main cause of Amazon deforestation.
They have the grass fields.
Yeah,
over there. I mean, Brazil and Argentina.
Yeah,
and
they're clearing forests for that. Yeah.
I don't know when.
Yeah. Okay, guys, you can go look for yourself what the leading cause of Amazon deforestation is. It's cattle ranching. So check it out.
Did you know?
Brazilian, and you know, I grew up in Brazil, and you know, the 95% of the Amazon destruction, unfortunately, is to grass-fed.
Yeah, but why haven't they gone to factory farming and just feeding them crops? Why
are
they
better? It'll be better, but I don't know why.
But why have they taken down forests to basically because they need more land. Why would
the
they?
Demand, I guess, for grass-fed beef. Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah. So if you
I don't think the demand is that big because people really, I mean, if they look at the piece of meat, they don't know whether it's grass-fed or grain-fed. So I don't think the demand for grass-fed beef is that big.
Currently, nearly half of all United States land is already dedicated to animal agriculture. If we were to switch over to grass-fed beef, it would require clearing every square inch of the United States, up into Canada, all of Central America, and well into South America. And this is just to feed the United States demand on meat.
I think there's plenty of grassy knolls, grassy fields to grow the grass-fed beef.
Let's just say you found out, that it grass-fed was clearing forests, it wasn't sustainable, it was hurting the environment, and it was killing these individual animals. Would that change your position?
You're speaking hypothetically. Let's say, for example, I could ask you the same question. Let's say you found out that all the plants were being factory farmed and pesticides and fertilizers and everything. Would you switch to animal products?
I would switch to the one that causes the least harm.
Exactly, eggs and dairy and stuff, right? I mean,
they're exploiting, enslaving, and killing individuals, and they're eating plants.
That's kind of vegan propaganda that they're slaving and they're keeping them in chains. I mean. Again, I don't approve of factory farming.
That's where over 90% of our meat and stuff comes from. So that's probably the main issue, yeah?
Yeah.
Answer your question.
So basically we agree that the problem is factory farming.
It's the most of the problem, but grass-fed wouldn't solve that problem.
No.
You know, this plant-based would solve that problem. But so I would choose the one that caused the least harm. What would you choose?
I know, but do you know the numbers? I mean, you say it's not sustainable. I mean, if we went grass-fed and everything.
But that figure doesn't even take into consideration that much of that land isn't suited to graze livestock. We would have to convert all mountain ranges to grassland, clear ancient forests and national parks to grazing, and demolish every city just to make room to graze cows.
Well, we could both research that. I could give you a source that could give you some verifiable
and
sources.
And again, what we agreed on, there's too many of us. There's how many? 7-8 billion?
7 billion.
Seven.
All eating grass-fed beef.
No.
They need lots of land. Their cows are obviously causing greenhouse gases.
And if you produce or grow the plants the way they're supposed to be grown, how much land would it take?
Well, let's just say we found a way of doing plant agriculture in a more sustainable, less harmful way.
Let's say we found a way to do grass-fed animals.
But we're still harming the animal when we bolt gun them and slice them up.
That's what we agree on is that neither of us likes animals being tortured.
So I don't like them being harmed at all. So a bolt gun.
I don't like them being harmed either. That's why it's.
We're the same then.
We
have the same.
Of course, yeah.
Idea.
Yeah, but that's if you obviously don't know the way a humane slaughterhouse works. Basically, there's a spiral. So so let's say the cow doesn't see other cows suffer or die or anything.
Yeah.
So and it's very quick. So basically, they don't see or feel anything. It's very instantaneous.
Do you think that's humane if they don't see it or feel it? Put yourself in their position, or put a dog in their position. I'm trying to get you to switch over and say, would that be humane for me? Because I wouldn't want that done to me, personally. I think that would be really scary.
Well, let's go to a movie. Let's say Planet of the Apes, right?
Yeah.
So apes are ruling the planet, right, that we live on, let's say Earth.
Yeah.
And if they had been eating us from the beginning of times, then they would be doing that to us, basically. We have been eating animals from the beginning of time, so.
Yeah.
But you're comparing.
Does that make it?
You're comparing apples to oranges.
Does that make it right if we've been doing it since the beginning of time? Like if the apes had been enslaving us and eating us since the beginning of time.
Let's take death row inmates. Do you have a preference whether they're being injected poisons or they get the air gun?
Death row inmates, and how does that relate to killing innocent animals?
No, I'm just saying. But you're comparing killing animals that we've eaten all along to killing people,
I was saying if you think there's a humane way to kill an animal, do you think there's a humane way to take a dog's life or your own life? If you want to live, if you have an interest in living, that's what I was trying to say with that. I was just trying to say, if it's humane for the cow, the individual cow, would it be humane for someone like you who has an interest in living?
Let's take the area of land where the plants are grown. Would you think it's humane if you and him and your families and your whole city was living on a, I don't know, 100 meters per 100 meters, land, you were all together? It's not humane either. So basically...
Wait, who gets hurt from that again? What individual gets slaughtered from that?
No, is it humane?
Humane.
Yeah, I mean, if you live all next to each other.
So we're using this land to sustain ourselves with the plants and. I don't understand.
Basically, it's vegan bullshit right now, right?
It's vegan bullshit.
It's vegan bullshit because you're taking very illogical facts, basically. Illogical. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, because I'm giving you examples. Kind of similar, but you're talking apples and oranges.
Okay, yeah, I'm trying to understand your analogies.
But you're just attacking the people that are eating animals, even if they're doing it the best way possible.
Oh, I think it's better, for sure.
Yeah,
and it might be better, but we've always been doing it.
But then again, you're coming back to killing someone. Let's say if plants, they have research that plants actually, with the wind and everything, they communicate to each other.
They react to stimuli in the environment, mm-hmm. yeah?
And they actually start producing more poison and everything.
They react to stimuli.
Insects, yeah. If the insects eat them, they produce more poison. So basically, they don't have a soul. Per se, but
they don't have sentient consciousness.
Yeah.
So they can't experience suffering. So they don't have a subjective experience. Yeah.
Yeah. So
they're different to a cow.
All in all, maybe we should be eating rubber or something because.
We go for the one that causes the least amount of harm. Mm-hmm. And if plants can't feel pain or they can't experience fear mm-hmm. or suffering, we'd go for them.
I get your point. Yeah. I mean, again, I don't like animals being tortured, enslaved, suffering. I don't like any of that.
No one does. And there's a percentage of people that might, but yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
All there. But I can tell that you care.
I do.
Enough, and you've looked into this a bit. Yeah. To choose free range, you're having a conscious decision, which I admire. But
then again, I mean, let's come back to the plants. If you were really ethical about everything you ate and everything, the way you are about protecting animals and not seeing animals suffer, then...
Not just suffer, by the way. Get harmed.
Get harmed and everything. Yeah. Why don't you eat all organic? I mean, because you're eating pesticides.
But pesticides doesn't harm...
Really? Do you know that?
Harm as many animals as...
They actually do, I mean, because you're saying that the animals, factory-farmed animals, which is 90%, you said, right? They get...
Eat pesticide-laden plants.
Exactly, the soy and stuff, that's what you said, right? So if the animals are being harmed also, if they eat poison, basically, are they not?
Animals are being harmed? The animals are being harmed if they eat the poison.
I don't eat those animals. They get cancers and...
I don't eat those animals.
But you're eating the plants.
I'd be eating the plants,
yeah. Yeah, exactly. Eating glyphosate, basically.
I'm eating the... Yeah,
Do you know glyphosate?
Yeah, but that's my choice.
And that's my choice.
But there's no there's no victim in my choice.
There is.
There's less. Less. So, there's animals that die in plant agriculture.
You know the ties between cancer and all the other diseases and glyphosate and the poisons? So, there's victims.
Individual human beings that are victims of eating pesticide?
I mean, they don't die the very second that they eat the pesticides or the glyphosate.
They develop diseases. And basically. They might,
I mean, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But... there's no sort of direct victim. We're not killing an animal at the same time.
The same thing. If you don't have an argument, then we're killing animals, you know?
As well as eating pesticide plants. So if
can you see the big picture? If you look at the big picture, then what we agree on is factory farming is bad. Whether you do it to plants or animals, right?
No. I don't think plants have moral value like an animal does. I think
plants. So you think it's okay to use the poisons and glyphosate and everything on the plants?
I think there's a better way. Hmm. But I think we should deal with the main issue, which is these individual animals that are going to slaughterhouses for no reason when we can.
Now you're coming back the same argument basically. Yeah. When you have a
It's the main issue.
No, it's not. I mean, if you do it in a humane way and the animal doesn't suffer and all its life it gets to eat grass and be free on the grass.
They don't live all their life. You know that. They only live 2 years of their life. They should live to their 20.
So
we cut it off really short.
If they're grown ethically, then they live longer. Usually it's 10 years and more.
10?
Yeah.
I've never seen a farm like that. Never.
No. Okay. I have back home because the place I get my meat from, I know everything about them, basically. The slaughterhouse thing, the way they're raised.
And they're 10 years old?
They're close to 10 now.
So they're half their lifespan. No,
basically what they do is, you mean the animals are 10?
The animals are 10 years old when they get slaughtered.
At least.
Wow, so that's half their lifespan.
Do you know? I have a friend, and he used to work in Australia because that's what a lot of young people do, right? And he told me he worked at this farm, and the family had a huge cattle ranch.
Yeah,
and they had animals, cows that were 20 years old, and basically they died of old age.
Okay.
So what happened? The family said they would usually what they would do is bury the animals, but McDonald's buys them, and McDonald's
they die of old age.
Yeah, and McDonald's buys the animals.
So that would be the most ethical way. To if an animal dies of old age, mm-hmm. you can go and eat their body if you want. That animal hasn't been the life hasn't been taken by you.
Do you know
roadkill?
So basically, it's.
But that's your choice. Mm-hmm. It's your choice.
What do you think about the hunting and killing your own food?
Well, I think if you don't have to do it to survive or to be healthy mm-hmm. or to look like John, then I think it's unnecessary.
Probably looking like John is unnecessary, also. I mean, even looking like me, you don't have to look like this. I mean,
no, you don't have
to. We can all look like you.
Yeah. Well, if I'm healthy and happy, exactly. then why should I go out and shoot an animal in the head?
If you need a food, yeah, then.
If I was going to starve to death.
Yeah, exactly.
But we're not in that situation, me and you, right now.
Well, the problem is. We're so advanced, that's why we're not in that situation.
Yeah, exactly.
If we weren't as advanced, we would probably be all eating bananas here, right?
That's so true, what you just said.
And
we're advanced.
And if we, both of us, all three of us, would be living where I'm from, Northern Europe, basically.
Yeah.
It's October, middle of October almost. We wouldn't be able to eat any plants.
Oh, we can import plants there, yeah?
No, if we weren't as advanced, basically.
But we are advanced.
If we were hunter-gatherers, then we would all three of us would be eating meat right now.
That's a hypothetical. We're not. We're in this society right now. Is it justified in this society?
But then when I hypothetically the same way you talked about Bali and bananas, then you agreed. But when I talked about Northern Europe and animals, then you don't agree.
No, that's because you're saying that we're hunter and gatherers, mm-hmm. like back then, but that's justified back then. It's not justified now.
If we weren't as advanced and we were in Bali and then we would be eating bananas and everything's okay, right? Because bananas.
If we weren't as advanced, if we had no choice, I wouldn't be even having this discussion with you. We don't have a choice, but we have a choice.
Yeah.
No, we do. We have a choice.
Yeah.
Like in this society now. Yeah?
Mm-hmm. But do you think it's, I mean, the importation of all the foods and everything, that's normal? And
but it's like we have a choice to either kill animals or not.
And that's the thing. We have a choice to grow our food ethically. I mean, not to even grow our food, but the food that we buy.
Yeah, we do.
We have a choice.
We could make that next step.
With our dollars. That's, I mean, the more we buy of the good food, the more they produce of it.
Supply and demand.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. Then why are you eating? Why are you eating glyphosate and pesticides?
So if we all voted for free range meat, all of us, 7 billion of us, that's how many animals go into slaughterhouses unnecessarily when we have plants to eat?
Same argument again. You're probably going to mention slaughterhouses and killing animals 10 more times if we continue this conversation, but I'm making valid points. So basically, the point is things are screwed up now, right?
Things are screwed up.
Yeah, factory farming, pesticides, all that shit, and too many people and...
Pollution and stuff like that.
Well, pollution doesn't really affect our food that much.
Pollution doesn't?
I mean, not directly.
The way, like, bolt gunning a cow does, for instance.
Yeah, or like... spraying poison over.
Bro, we're gonna have to end that there, but thanks so much for your debate.
All right, guys, leave your comments down below. Who do you think won this debate, the bodybuilder or the vegan?